And joining me now is Code Pink's Ariel Gold, a former clerk for Judge Kavanaugh, Jennifer Mascott, and a former advisor for both President Bush and Vice President Cheney, Mary Matlin. And first to Ariel, got to go to Ariel. Democrats kind of complained that they wanted an FBI investigation. Now they got it. And now they're whining that it's not enough. What is enough? Zero corroborating evidence, 46 pages. Even Susan Collins seems to say it's very thorough.
I think the real question is why so many women Republican senators are not caring about the experiences of women. And specifically, I was in Susan Collins's office tonight with a bunch of protesters, most of whom were her own constituents, and she refused to come and meet with them.
So you just barged in? Is that your new tactic?
Why shouldn't constituents be in the office of their representative?
Well, were they, you know, that sound of the screaming earlier at the elevator? Do you think anyone finds that in any way enticing, influential, attractive, convincing? The screaming is not convincing. It's kind of just cover your ears stuff. I don't understand how you guys think that's working. Obviously, flamed out in this event, in this effort. You guys flamed out.
We saw over 300 people arrested today, thousands of people taking over the Senate building. This was people power, democracy in action.
Do you guys have any jobs? Like, how do you guys do that? I know you're Code Pink. I don't know if you get paid. Do you get paid by Code Pink?
I am on staff with Code Pink, yes.
Okay, so you get paid to do this. I assume a lot of the other people there are either taking time off from work or their mommy and daddy are paying their bills still.
Because
I mean, how does that work?
This affects generations to come. This is a lifetime appointment. I myself am the mother of two children. My daughter is 15. And I shudder to think of what this means for her, the message that she's getting.
You're worried that your daughter will not be able to what?
I'm worried that my daughter is getting a message from Congress that her experiences, that her safety is not important.
But is it about abortion? So you're worried your daughter would not be able to get an abortion?
I'm also worried that my daughter will not have the right to control her own reproduction.
I just want to know what we're talking about. There are multiple things that I'm worried about with my daughter. Okay, that's fine. I just want to know what we're talking about. Mary Matlin, you don't do a lot of TV anymore, but you know Brett Kavanaugh. You've known him for years. He was the Bush staff secretary. It's not like he's a Trump Republican. He was a Bush guy, a Bush appointee on the D.C. circuit. But Mary, you saw this play out today. There's a lot of enthusiasm, a lot of anger, a lot of agitation on the left. They feel like they have momentum, even if they lose the fight against Kavanaugh. How do you see it?
It's anarchy. This is not civil discourse. It's anarchy, and it's destruction of the culture. We're sissifying men. You know, in my day of feminism, there's always been like a virulent strain of a woman needs a man like a fish needs a bike. So we've gone from not needing men. Today's feminists want to castrate men, emasculate men. You know what's going to affect generations of people to come when men are behaving like sissies and women are behaving like anarchists? And that's the definition of successful feminism. It's not, if you want to stand up for women, what about Ashley, sweet little Ashley Kavanaugh, who sat outside President Bush's office, the epitome of class and decorum. Brett, who had the hardest job, by my estimation, in the White House, as staff secretary, which requires absolute, unequivocal discretion and again, decorum. This huge record today, his friend, Joel Kaplan, who's a friend of ours, is being attacked at Facebook. They're probably going to run him out of there because he attended the hearing of Brett Kavanaugh, whose wedding he was in and has been friends with for 20 years. People are really, this is transcends politics, Laura. This is really, really about culture. And people are sick of everything from this idiocracy that's infusing and permeating every element of our culture, from football to public restrooms.
This, you can't get away from it.
Of the You cannot go anywhere.
You can't do anything. Because everybody has to be angry. Go ahead, quickly.
Of the many incredible, miraculous things that President Trump has done, and this is nothing short of a miracle what he's got done, but he's done it in the face of constant thwarting and lying and fallaciousness and these viral attacks on him and his person and his people. They're chasing his cabinet members and his staff out of restaurants. They're sending a private information of senators. He has exposed the hypocrisy and the ineptitude of the loyal opposition, Danang Dick and Senator Spartacus. And people are tuning in and they're saying, who are these people? I'm in New Orleans. Like, who is this Blumenthal guy who's, or their Ellison, who's, what is the standard? We don't even know
now,
what the standard
is anymore.
You have a picture of your wife, your girlfriend being beat up, and you have medical records, and you have no corroboration on Brett Kavanaugh, and you're blowing up his life and his friend's life. People are really, to transcend politics.
Jennifer, I want to go to you. The cover of Time magazine, which you probably have seen, this is like all over the place. We're going to put it up on the screen so people see it. And it's a letter to white women who support Brett Kavanaugh. We need you to stand with women who are breaking the silence in spite of their terror and shame. I believe inside the bodies of some of those women who laughed at the rally were other impulses and feelings they weren't expressing. Time is short. Call your senators. Stop laughing and start fighting. That was Eve Ensler, of course, Vagina Monologues, right? Vagina Monologues, am I getting that right, Raymond? Yes. It's kind of like, you white women, how dare you laugh at survivors? How dare you dismiss survivors? And that's kind of an emotional thing. If someone is a survivor of sexual assault, no one should laugh at them.
Right,
no one wants to laugh at them. Yet this is not how I think a lot of fair-minded people are seeing at least this particular case.
So my background, of course, as you know, is I clerked for Judge Kavanaugh his first year, and he's an excellent jurist, and he himself has a lot of care for women. More than half of his law clerks were women. He's really done an amazing job of mentoring us, keeping up with us over the years.
I know, we all know that. We've heard that. I don't mean to interrupt you, but anything that you saw when you were working for him, and he's a judge for 12 years, 12 times 3, 36 clerks, right, about?
So, yes, 48.
Or so, 48
yes.
clerks. Okay, so you had more than my time at the Court of Appeals. 48 clerks. Anything you saw in his behavior toward the more than half of the clerks being women would give you pause about the way he treats women?
Absolutely not. Absolutely.
Nothing.
Character. No, nothing. Character.
Nothing untoward. Nothing a little.
Nothing anywhere close to anything like that. Absolutely gracious, patient, respectful, perfectly above board.
So were you shocked to hear of these allegations when they first were leaked to The Washington Post?
It was shocking. You know, Judge Kavanaugh along the way, the entire time, has categorically denied them. And, you know, they're totally inconsistent with everything that I've known about him or seen in his presence. And, you know, he's been an advocate for fair law and fair application of the law and for women and men and training up the next generation of lawyers. And I think if the Senate confirms him to the Supreme Court, he will apply the Constitution fairly and really try to look forward to justice for all Americans.
All right. Ariel, what's next for Code Pink? You guys lost this round. He's going to get confirmed. What next?
Well, we're not done, and we're going to be out there again tomorrow and the next day.
Doing what?
We're going to be out there in the halls and in the streets calling for
what?
Somebody who to for him to step down and for us to
him
have
to step down?
A nomination of somebody with a different temperament, of somebody who hasn't lied under oath, of somebody who doesn't have these accusations. And there is tons of people that have squeaky clean records that we could see be nominated.
Okay, so you'd be in favor of Amy, like Coney Barrett, if she took his place, a woman, very strong woman, she has seven kids, you'd be in favor of a woman?
I'm not saying that I would be in favor of them politically, but I think that that's a more appropriate nomination.
Okay, we got Code Pink on the record.